Hi, welcome to art. My name is Sherry Altieri, and I teach 6th, 7th, and 8th grade accelerated art here at Unionvale Middle School. And I've actually been working in the Arlington Central School District for 14 years, and I've worked at both the elementary and high school levels before making my choice to come permanently to middle school art, where my heart lies. My philosophy is that anyone can create art. Art isn't that different than learning an instrument or a sport. It takes practice, but there are techniques that I can show your child and show my students that will make it easier. But the more they practice, the better they will get. I also believe that art can be so many different things, and we're not limited in our definition of what art can be. Music is art, dance is art, cooking, culinary arts, fashion, design, construction. And I want you to think a little bit about your creative outlet, because a lot of the parents and guardians I talk to say, oh, I'm not an artist, but then they'll tell me about the amazing things they bake when they're at home, or the way they've designed their home or fashion. They might tell me about a car that they've taken apart and put back together again in a new way. Guess what? You're an artist. My goals are to help your child find their lifelong passion in the arts. What is the thing that they really love to create? Maybe it's drawing, maybe it's painting, but maybe it's a very different definition of art. Maybe they're more into computer arts or design. Maybe they're more of a builder. But my job is to help them find their passion for the arts. I also want to help them build their creative problem-solving skills, because my job is to prepare your child for an unknown future in the 21st century. And I don't know what kind of careers are going to be out there for your child in 10, 20, 30 years. So how can I prepare them for something that I know nothing about? Well, my answer to that is to give them creative problem-solving skills that they can use in any area of their life or career. I also want to expose them to the wider world and other cultures and ideas through the arts. And I want them to become more confident in their abilities through the arts. The arts are a way that children can build self-confidence. One of the things that I get asked about a lot is assessment or grading in art. And I think that also comes from our experiences as a child and as a student in art classes. Yes, in middle school, your child does receive a number grade in art. And yes, we are giving out number grades now, even though we're learning remotely. Assignments are posted in Google Classroom, but we're still using School Tool and Parent Portal for the final grades, so you can check the grade that your child gets. Can your child redo something? Always, always, always. They can always submit late or missing work. They can always redo and add more for a higher grade. They have until the end of the marking period to do that. So if you see that your child is missing a project, encourage them to submit it. If they have a grade that's not as high as they would like, or you think they can do better, they can always resubmit it. That's the way the art process works. We're always creating something, looking at it, and asking ourselves and reflecting on how we might change it and make it better. Now, one of the things that I'm asked a lot about with grades is how do you do it? How do you assess? And I think that comes from our own experiences as children and as students in the art room, where we would get a number grade, but we would have no idea how our teacher came up with that grade. So I use rubrics, and it's really important for me to let you know that I use rubrics that are based on studio habits of mind. Your child will never be assessed on whether I think their art is good or bad, because that's subjective. That's not fair. So instead, I use the studio habits of mind. And the studio habits are different ways of thinking through the arts to develop not just art skills to help them as artists, but to help them as creative problem solvers and to help them as independent, confident young people in the 21st century. So we look at things like, can you engage and persist when you have a challenge? That's a skill they can use in any area. Can they envision different ideas and come up with a plan and steps to help them bring that idea to fruition? Can they express themselves? Can they observe the world around them and think critically? Can they reflect on things that they've done? Can they stretch and explore past their comfort zone? And can they reach out to their community, to their peers, to other artists, and just other students and colleagues in the future to help them become better versions of themselves and to learn and grow? So I really love these studio habits of mind, and my rubrics will focus on 2, 3, or 4 different habits of mind. And I don't expect them to be perfect each time, but I do want them to try and grow these skills. And I give them feedback to help them grow as artists and as young individuals of the 21st century. I do have a sample rubric on the screen. It's hard to see, but this was a rubric that your child just recently used in Google Classroom. And it talks about how they were asked to develop crafts, stretch and explore and express. And I always post the rubrics with the art project assignments, but a lot of your children are still learning how to open up the rubric and look at it. So I continue to remind them of the different habits that we're focusing on. And more importantly, remind them it's not about whether your artwork came out perfect or not, because life is not perfect. In Google Classroom, probably one of the most valuable things your child can learn, and maybe even you could do too, is to check for current assignments. So I want to show you how to do that in Google Classroom quick, because a lot of students don't even realize that there's a link that says view your work that they can click on. They don't even realize it's a clickable link, and it will show them their artwork that's been graded. It will show the missing work. And this is something that's not just for Google Classroom and art, but for any Google Classroom that they use. So in order to do that, they have to go to their class, and up at the top, there's a whole bunch of different tabs. And the classwork tab is the one where they can view their work. So you'll notice on the stream tab, the main screen that they go to, there is upcoming work, but that'll only show you assignments that are coming up soon. It won't show you anything in the past. So I always encourage my students to go to classwork, and up here in the upper left-hand corner is this icon that says view your work. If you're using an Apple device, it's just the icon with the clipboard and the face on it. So a lot of students don't realize they can click that, but I want your students to click on that link, your child to click on that link, and it will come up with a list of all the assignments that they've done in that particular class. It'll say what they're missing. It'll say what they've turned in. It will even give them scores. So you can go through and they can go through and find their assignments. On the left-hand side, it's even broken down for them. You also will want to click view details if you're looking at it, and that will give you all of the information on the assignment and how they got the different scores they did. And again, they can always go in, open up their assignment, and resubmit it. And that sends a notification to their teachers that they would like to resubmit their work. Another thing that a lot of children have a hard time with is inserting images of their artwork into Google Slides or whatever way they have to insert a work of physical art that they've been doing outside of the classroom. How do they get that onto the computer? So I do have a section at the bottom of Google Classroom for general questions and just some videos and how to. And you'll notice the last one that I have there is how to insert an image into Google Slides. And we've been talking about this a lot, but sometimes when your child is working at night or over the weekend, they can forget and they can struggle. And you can always email me, you can always contact me, but a good place or a good reminder might be to tell them to go to Google Classroom and at the bottom of the classwork tab, go to some of those general questions and how to FAQs or the tech resources. And there's a lot of videos for general questions that students have. However, I do always encourage you to contact me. You can always email me, you can always text me, and I'm always happy to help. I want to end by telling you about an opportunity for your children. Here at Unionville Middle School, we have an 8th grade accelerated art program. This is actually a high school art class that your child can take in 8th grade, and they actually receive a half high school art credit for this class. However, we only have a limited number of spaces, So if your child is interested, if they love art, they don't have to be an amazing artist yet, but if they really love art and they want it in their life, this is something that they have to apply for during their seventh grade year. Honestly, I'm not sure what that's going to look like this year. It might be a remote application, but encourage your child to consider it, encourage them to save images of their artwork. And if they do end up applying for and becoming accepted into the eighth grade accelerated art program, this will usually replace a study hall. But in the spring of their seventh grade year, their guidance counselor will contact them and talk about their eighth grade schedule and how eighth grade art would fit in. Please contact me if you ever have any questions or concerns, or if there's something going on that you need me to know about. I'm always happy to help. Thank you so much for checking out my video, and thank you so much for your support of the arts. I hope you get to see some art in the Hudson Valley. I hope you get to discover your own creative passions and share that with your child. Thank you.